I came to work there in 1960. There were about just a few males and about 100 females. An interesting environment of electronic assembly. When he was going into the hobby of making telescopes, diverting funds to support his hobby, other people got very frustrated.
The only way to make the other people involved in this business happy was if I sold telescopes as part of the business. So I formed this division of Valor Electronics called Celestronic Division of Valor Electronics. Prepared an ad, took pictures of the project, and sent them off as a page advertisement in SkyTel.
The result was the first commercially available Schmidt-Cassegrain telescope, the Celestronic 20, unveiled in 1964 through a series of ads in Sky and Telescope magazine. This telescope made Celestron Pacific, at that time still a division of Valor Electronics, an overnight sensation of the astronomical community.
Clearly, when Celestron came on the scene, I think they put larger aperture, good quality telescopes within the reach of the amateur community, and certainly enabled amateurs to do types of observations that would have required a much more expensive telescope to have done earlier.
Tom's revolutionary techniques developed for that first 20-inch Schmidt-Cassegrain were the foundation for what was to become an award-winning line of telescopes ranging in size from a portable 6-inch to an observatory-class 22-inch. Celestron telescopes soon took the astronomy community by storm, finding home anywhere from classrooms to remote observatories.
This is the 16-inch Celestron telescope that was originally installed here at El Camino College back in 1969. To this day, it's still used on a nightly basis for the astronomy classes that go on here in the deck and for public viewing and open houses. In addition to the 16-inch observatory that we have here, El Camino also has a whole fleet of smaller Celestron telescopes that the students actually use to make observations. The telescopes are very similar to this one in optical design, but they're smaller and they have a whole lot of different bells and whistles. They have integrated GPS and they have swing motors so they can find any object in the sky, and they have a database of 40,000 objects. But the optics in it really haven't changed that much since this telescope was put in back in 1969. It was just in this last year that we introduced the Edge HD optical design, which is really an improvement and modification of the Schmidt-Cassegrain design that Tom Johnson originally learned how to mass produce.
The 8-inch Schmidt-Cassegrain model designed by Tom Johnson a few years later went on to become the famous Celestron 8, or C8 for short, the most popular and best-selling amateur telescope of all time. Nearly all astronomers today, young and old, have either owned or used a C8 at some point in their life.
You know, I think in the early teens, I got that subscription to Sky and Telescope, and I joined the Astronomy Club in Tucson, and that was it. And I remember going to star parties, and I had, you know, that little dinky refractor, and it was when you went to the star party, and there was the guy with the 8-inch Celestron. That was the one that would have been cool to own. That was the one I wanted to hang out and see what the Orion Nebula looked like in his telescope, because I knew that in mine, it was only so-so.
For a long time, because Celestron was the one to bring the Schmidt-Cassegrain to the amateur market, and this compact telescope that was very versatile, and it was called a C8. And other companies made Schmidt-Cassegrains through the years, but everyone kind of just referred to them as C8s. You know, an 8-inch Schmidt-Cassegrain, which stands for a Celestron 8, but even if it was made by some other company, you know, when I first got into this hobby, people would call, oh, I have a C8, you know, because and they may have had a different brand, but they called it a C8 because that is what the standard was in the industry. That's what Celestron, that's what Celestron brought to the amateur market and how it changed the amateur market, is it created this, you know, fairly low cost, very versatile system that's compact. And there was just nothing like it. Before that, we had big long Newtonians or little refractors. So Schmidt-Cassegrain, what Tom Johnson did, you know, is an incredible thing to the amateur market.
In later years, Tom Johnson sold Celestron and went on to give lectures and presentations at various astronomical and scientific conventions. He is presently retired and lives in the picturesque city of Lake Arrowhead, California. Although he had to let go of his passion for flying airplanes, he still takes to the skies with his Celestron telescope. The technological achievements of Tom Johnson's generation are undeniable and permeate through all aspects of modern life. Our society is in great debt to the generation of dreamers and doers who put a man on the moon and brought distant worlds closer to Earth. Their passion to invent and ambition to make a mark were truly unrivaled through the history of mankind. When asked why he decided to pursue telescope making rather than focusing on a successful electronic components business, Tom does not hesitate with the answer.
It got to be kind of boring because how will I make a mark in the world of these tiny little pulse transformers that I made?
And make a mark he did. Tom's unyielding quest for optical perfection created a new industry and gained him national recognition.
Some years later, which was very exciting for him and for the company, was he was awarded the Richardson Medal, which is an award by the Optical Society of America. And he was the only person in 18 years who ever received this award that didn't have a doctorate in optics or in optical engineering, which was kind of exciting because he was one of the gurus in compound cathode optic systems in the country.
He wanted to make a mark. What was he going to be remembered for? And he will be remembered forever. His name and pictures are in many books. Our products in Celestron will be around forever. And Tom is the founder of not only Celestron, but an industry. Light, portable, quality telescopes that bring a lot of enjoyment to millions of people.